Crystal Palace opted for Frank de Boer over Mauricio Pellegrino as new manager. Crystal Palace are edging closer to appointing a successor to Sam Allardyce after the former Ajax and Internazionale manager Frank de Boer was offered the role at Selhurst Park. The Palace chairman, Steve Parish, with guidance from the club's American major shareholders, David Blitzer and Josh Harris, has conducted an exhaustive month-long process scrutinising the credentials of candidates following Allardyce's surprise resignation last month. The former Alavés manager Mauricio Pellegrino and de Boer impressed, with the Dutchman now the preferred choice. Pellegrino is expected to replace Claude Puel at Southampton. The finer details of the contract for de Boer, 47, are being discussed, with the makeup of his backroom staff also to be determined. Yet the club are confident of striking a deal early next week that would most likely result in the former Dutch international being confirmed as Palace's fifth permanent manager in 4 years. He will have some leeway in the transfer market, though Palace were heavy spenders in January, when their top flight status was under serious threat, and that outlay will be reflected in the funding provided by the board for strengthening. The first team squad are due back for pre-season training on 2 July and will contest the Premier League trophy in Hong Kong next month. De Boer has been out of work since leaving Inter, where he had succeeded Roberto Mancini, after only 3 months last November. His 14 games brought 5 wins, deemed unacceptable at a volatile club, yet he had established his coaching credentials more persuasively at Ajax, for whom he had excelled over 11 years as a player. He had returned in 2007 as a youth coach and went on to take charge of the first team over a six-season spell that yielded 4 Eredivisie titles. The Dutchman would be Palace's first foreign appointment as manager, although Adelio Lombardo and Thomas Brolin did spend an ill-fated period in caretaker charge in 1998. Parish, who is abroad, had been approached by Marco Silva's representative once it became clear that the Portuguese was leaving Hull, but rather than wait to meet the Palace chairman, Silva secured terms at Watford. The credentials of Sean Dyche at Burnley and the former Stoke Town manager Christophe Galtier were also assessed, and the former England manager Roy Hodgson is understood to have expressed a tentative interest. Allardyce's departure constituted a shock, coming days after he had secured the club's 14th place finish and an unprecedented 5th successive season in the top flight. Since you're here, we have a small favor to ask. More people are reading The Guardian than ever, but advertising revenues across the media are falling fast. And unlike many news organizations, we haven't put up a paywall. We want to keep our journalism as open as we can. So you can see why we need to ask for your help. The Guardian's independent, investigative journalism takes a lot of time, money and hard work to produce. But we do it because we believe our perspective matters, because it might well be your perspective, too. I appreciate there not being a paywall. It is more democratic for the media to be available for all and not a commodity to be purchased by a few. I'm happy to make a contribution so others with less means still have access to information. Thomas CNFR. If everyone who reads our reporting, who likes it, helps to support it, our future would be much more secure.